the first moments of a baby's life. Magical. But for the parents, the responsibilities can also be daunting. How to keep your child safe and protected? One way, they're told, bank your baby's cord blood.
Umbilical cord blood happens to have a large number of young blood-making cells in there. So the cord blood, there is no question, it is life-saving.
Cord blood is full of precious stem cells. Thousands of life-saving transplants have been done using them. They're especially successful at treating sick kids.
Hi!
Come on in, guys!
Yay, look, we've been invited in! Go on!
What is it?
Lila.
Lila, hi. Come on in.
My goodness, such cuties.
These three moms have each paid thousands of dollars to store their children's cord blood.
What was the process that you went through to make up your mind about whether to do it or not?
What I had heard about is mostly is how much it can help, potentially help, in the future with certain diseases.
I didn't, and I still don't really see sort of any cons.
Yeah.
It's such an invaluable thing.
Investment, basically.
To do an investment insurance, really.
It's insurance,
sort of how I look at it.
You know, knock on wood, God forbid anything was to ever happen. Should something happen and I had made that choice not to store for her, I don't think I could ever forgive myself.
Of course, in a perfect world, they would never have to cash in on this investment.
Pregnant, congratulations.
In the last decade, hundreds of private companies have popped up worldwide capitalizing on the magic of stem cells.
Did you store your children's cord blood?
Of course I did.
It's reportedly a billion-dollar industry. Your doctor
will do the... Why choose Inception Life Bank?
Inception Life Bank is the largest private cord blood bank in Canada. They say they have stored cord blood from 70,000 babies. For $2,000 to $3,000, they promise peace of mind. Anu, Colleen, and Gillian gave birth in different hospitals, but they all went with Inception Life Bank.
What do you think are the chances if you guys needed to use the cord blood, if your child, worst case scenario, had leukemia? Do you think that is your understanding that that could be used to help them?
Absolutely.
Yes. Yeah, I mean, yeah. Nothing's guaranteed. I mean, it's not 100%, but my understanding is that's one of the main things that it could help with.
That was a key factor in their decision. So was the reputation of Inception and the seeming endorsement of the company by leading hospitals.
And did it help you feel more confident or comfortable, the fact that a company you chose had an office right at the inside the hospital?
It did, yeah. Them being right sort of in the same area as all the obstetricians sort of gave me a lot of confidence. That even in my discussion with the representative, I was really comfortable with everything she had to say.
We wanted to know more about what Inception says to prospective moms. Mount Sinai is one of a few hospitals where the company has an office. It's also where Inception was founded by two scientists in 2004. So our pregnant CBC colleague made an appointment.
We're going to have a little bit of a consult to give me some more information about the services that they provide.
The very first thing you see when entering the women's unit? Posters advertising the private cord blood banking service.
How are you?
I'm good, thank you.
So, okay. The benefit about having your baby's stem cells is that it's your property, it's 100% match for this baby, and it's private family banking. Okay, so no one else can use it, no one else can touch it.
Here's what she was told about cord blood banking.
Dr. Donna Wall, one of the leading transplant specialists in Canada, agreed to watch the footage with us.
So this is my copy, but these are the different medical conditions that it can treat.
The representative hands us a list with 80 life-threatening diseases cord blood can treat.
Is it all proven to treat these?
Yes. Yeah, it's been, they've been treating that for over 2 decades. So in the world, with cord blood, there's been over 45,000 transfusions for pediatric patients.
Well, it's a factually correct statement.
Right.
You know, but it's out of context.
And here is why. Turns out, most of those 45,000 transplants were done thanks to the public cord blood banks.
Like organ transplantation, stem cell transplantation involves finding the best match.
It may not be widely known, but doctors can tap into worldwide public registries with almost a million donors for a match, and it's free. Back inside Mount Sinai, the pitch gets more specific.
But these are the different medical conditions that it can treat. Blood cancer, different types of cancers, different types of metabolic diseases, immune diseases, solid tumors.
There's elements of truth, you know, in what's being said. The cells can be used in that setting of treating some solid tumors. In the setting of leukemia, we would not use their own cells. In the setting of a genetic defect, we would not use their own cells because we'd be given the same problem back. It doesn't make sense.
It's our choice, the representative says, but we're also reminded that this is medical insurance for the baby.
Who knows, right? Your child might need it. I don't know.
So this is the life insurance part of the story. And this part I do have trouble with, because with the amount of data to support, or the lack of data to support this approach, it's just not fair to families, because you're hitting families at a vulnerable time. And for right now, it's an oversell.
Dr. Wall isn't alone. The American Academy of Pediatrics has this advice for families. Private storage of cord blood as biological insurance should be discouraged. There is one exception, where a child has a known genetic defect. In that case, if the mom gets pregnant again, the family might want to bank the sibling's cord blood.
Inception Cord Blood Program's state-of-the-art 16,000-square-foot facility.
Inception Life Bank says they are proud of the services they offer. In an email to the Fifth Estate, they say they have used sibling cord blood stored at Inception for treatments, and they also say they fund ongoing medical research involving the potential future utility of cord blood. When we come back, should a public hospital endorse a private service?
It's not a practice that a publicly funded hospital should actually promote.
It's a top hospital in bustling downtown Toronto.
We strive for new models of care that support...
Mount Sinai serves around 100,000 patients a year and specializes in women and infant care, as well as cancer treatment. It supplements public funding with private partnerships, like the one with Inception Life Bank. But how does that relationship work? We spent more than a year requesting documents from the hospital, and here's what we can tell you. In 2016, the hospital made more than $2.6 million from the sale of Inception to an Australian company. Documents show Mount Sinai agreed to give access to potential clients and permitted Inception to leverage the relationship with Mount Sinai Hospital to promote the cord blood program. For every unit of cord blood Inception banks through Mount Sinai, the hospital collects $125 and an annual fee of $50,000 from Inception.
It's not a practice that a publicly funded hospital should actually promote.
We took these documents and contracts to University of Toronto's health law and policy professor, Trudeau Lemons.
What stood out to you in those documents?
You have a public hospital, publicly funded hospital that provides services in the public healthcare system and that basically promotes indirectly privileged contact with patients. But I find it indeed disturbing that because of the funding that they receive for their service, that they're basically promoting a practice which I would say from a medical perspective doesn't seem to be the best standard of care.
It's not illegal for hospitals to outsource part of their facilities for money that presumably goes back to the hospital.
Yeah, so it may indeed not be illegal, but it doesn't make it right.
Mount Sinai wouldn't speak to us on camera, but in a statement they told us, the money they receive from Inception is used to support clinical research and other investments in patient care.
Do you like it here?
We meet up with the moms again to report back what we learned.
You guys probably saw, there's a list of like 80 things it's cured, right?
Yeah.
That list refers to procedures done through the public registry. It has, cord blood technically has cured from these 80 different types of diseases, but it's not, the source is not private.
That's really tricky and misleading.
Wow, okay. Huh. Very interesting.
We also share that if a child needs a transplant, in most cases, it can't be done using the child's own cord blood, because it likely would also contain the damaged cells.
You would want it to be a different person.
Mm-hmm. Those cells would have been present in the umbilical cord blood.
Hmm. Yes, child's DNA.
Which makes sense now, thinking about
I mean, it's all very logical when you explain it the way she explained it.
Like, how would you even know what questions to ask when I sort of signed up for it? Mm-hmm. Nobody told me that, you know, that, oh, actually, if she was to get leukemia, you know, you can't use her own. I feel like you're in a very, like, emotional state when you're making these decisions.
But at the end of the day, I find it, honestly, a little disheartening that this kind of information is not provided by our doctors.
By Inception's own account, they've stored the cord blood of 70,000 babies. And the number of those released for transplant? 14.
So if I came to you and I said, you know, we're expecting a child and we're considering doing this private cord blood banking for a child, what would you say to us?
It's not my role to tell you what how to live your life, but if you took that $2,000, I would put it towards the soccer fund, the piano lessons, all the other things that are going to go into helping you raise the world's best child.
Piano lesson is more useful in this case than banking.
Yeah.
On a final note, after our inquiries, Inception Life Bank changed its website to acknowledge that in the case of leukemia, the child's own cord blood would likely not be used. And as for Mount Sinai, they informed us this week that they have now put up a sign to acknowledge the hospital's financial interest in cord blood collected through Inception, and that a process is underway to identify further opportunities to improve transparency.